Oi.
Data processing. Okay, we develop
you look at the chart here, okay, this is what we have, the number of layers as a function of lateral size for both. There's a small difference. A small difference. If you take the statistics, here we have graphene and graphite. We consider graphite more than 10 layers. If you get the number, statistics of number, if you get the non-significant future sample, the same future sample, you have, for example, graphene, you have 95% of graphene and 5% of graphite in terms of number of layers. Okay? In terms of volume, it means 10% graphene and 9% graphite. So these guys here, they're very heavy. And they take 9% of the mass. If you do a right simplification, okay, process, you go to this chart. And then things change. In terms of number, no change, almost no change, because you take a little, a small amount of pieces. But in terms of volume, now you have 80% graphene and 20% graphite. Okay? Okay. This is a software that we developed. This is in the website. So this is open, people can use. We do a pre-treatment in the image. So the operator just places his image there, and then automatically we have all the statistics, number, area, volume, number of layers, distribution. You can click here, it gives information about a given flake. It shows in the image which flake is there. You can click in any flake here, and you get the statistics, how it's in distribution. Okay, so people can use this in a web page. The web page is www.mggraphene.com.br. Okay, so let's get to the solution or in the powder. Okay? If you do DLS, I show you, the lateral size is 350. If you get this chart here, this is the lateral size that you measure by DLS. If you get the run one, okay, it gives you something like 5 layers, 4 layers, and then you get this. Everything here is not shown. The point is, DLS is a dynamic light scattering. And these guys here, they scatter a lot of light. They scatter a lot of light. So you measure graphite, basically. Okay? So you pull your number up here, which is where everybody wants to stay. Okay? And everything here is just neglected. And the RAM pulls things down, I'll show you. So let's go to RAM. As I told you, these two demands give the shape, give the number of layers. Okay, and we build standard samples. With these standard samples, we do AFM, RAM, this is like an optical image, RAM mapping, AFM, and then we build this group of standard samples. This is 1 layer, 2 layer, 3 layers, 4, and so on. What we do is a principal component analysis, okay? This is a software that analyzes the main spectral features of your RAM band, okay? And then you decompose this in a matrix, and then you can build, okay, long story short, you can build, okay, a phase space, okay, with as many components as you consider is important. In this case, it's like 90%, 98% of the information that you see here, okay, can be decomposed in 2 components. Our brain does something like this. Okay? It does something like this. It's like your brain knows how to differentiate this very well, but it's not trivial. Okay? To explain why this has this shape and so on. So this is what the software does. Okay, now we have The software learns what is one layer, two layer, three, and so on. And every measurement that you do now, you can project in this space. Okay? This is a nice way to make a statistical analysis. And everything, you don't have to fit the curve. Okay? You just give the data, the software look at the data and say, okay, this looks like one layer, and so on. Then we take our samples. We have, for example, a few layer graphene goes here in this space, and then we can make the distribution, set like parameters. Okay, so this the probability is high to go for two layers, three layers, four layers, and then there's no sample here. Okay. The multi-layer graphene goes away because it's a centrifugation. This is the sample, and the graphite nanoplates that they can't, at the bottom, okay, of the solution, they are here. This is basically many layers in graphite, okay? We did this also, this is for the examples, this is for CVD graphene, like the NPL in the lab. We applied this method, we found like everything is monolayer almost for one area. In this area was expected to be monolayer. Another area, they expect to have a little bit of two layers, and we detect with this method. But here's the thing, when we compare, okay, our run data with the AFM, like this is like three conditions of centrifugation, okay? This is a very highly centrifuged sample. This is medium. This is almost no simplification. Okay? So it makes sense that you have one graphene here, one multi-layer here, one graphite here, but the AFM seem much more graphite. So this is like more than 10 layers. And in terms of mass, I showed you this is important. Okay? This is very important. This can be like 80% of the sample. So what's the thing here is that the 2D map, it misses the larger pieces. It doesn't classify it well. And I show you that the problem is, if we take a graphene, a liquid exfoliated graphene flake like this, okay, and you look in a TEM, in a transmission microscope, electron microscopy image like this, you see that the layers, they are detached. Okay? They are decoupled, but they are not detached. So here's the thing. If spectroscopically, if you look at this, the Raman will not be able to say, like, for example, if this is like two layers and two layers, the Raman will not say this is four layers. It will say it's two layers. But the AFM will show four layers. So the AFM is very physical, it's morphological. The Raman is not. Even for thicker pieces, if you look, the graphite that comes out of these shear methods, they are detached. So if you measure this piece here, there are many layers, you measure something like four layers. So this was very puzzling, and we took the conclusion that the 2D map is sensitive to interlayer coupling, not morphology. It tells you how your layers are decoupled that system, but not if they are detached. Okay? So we go to the dependent test, it scales with the material, the mass. Okay? We took some internal reference from the silicon peak, Raman peak, okay? And we built again with our standard samples. We did a 5 minutes, okay? We built a relation. Okay? And now we learn how to convert the dependent entity normalized by the simple peak with the number of layers. This is morphological too. This has been done for a few layers, and people have used HOPG, an external sample, as a reference. Okay? This is not practical for papers. So the G-band, the random G-band, reproduces very well the AFM data. Okay. It shows this technique. This is morphological. The 2D band shows the delay coupling. So they are very complementary, okay, but we have to be careful. Just the 2D band doesn't say if you have like loose, graphene, nice, small flakes. We did measurements in the same spot, same area, and this is the result we get. The G band really looks like the AFM, statistically they are very similar. And the 2D band just show that your flakes are just different. Okay, we also have this effective works. I don't have time to go to the details, but we measured the number of point defects and crystallite size by round 2. I just want to show this video, which is our software for round analysis we can also use. You just load your spectrum. There's like the wavelength, and the software scratches the baseline. You don't have to do a crazy fitting procedure here, and then you just get the results. You can look at the fitting, see if it's defined, crystallite size, point effect distance. You can look at the PCA analysis, see if you agree. This is something like 5 layers, looks like they agree. Okay, Isabella, the website. So we are also doing automatic. We are working to do automation for measuring the graphene in line. Okay. This the prototype is working. There's a small graphene line here with these small pumps. And the idea here is, okay, you have the liquid solution, you have the power plant, the pilot plant, okay? You have your solution. A lot of work to make this opening, okay? You have to open your sample, do the statistical measurements, you do run, map, you do AFM. And now, we are trying to do a machine learning. How is the opposite way? Okay, so if you have this, how this looks like? So this is a lot of data processing, and we are working with the visual computer science researchers to do a machine learning to learn, okay, a spectrum obtained in line, what would be this picture here if we take a specific spectrum in line. Okay? This is what we are doing now. We also are trying to do new methodologies, for example, for sample concentration, like the run of graphene in water. You have these water peaks. We are doing some relation between the intensity of the graphene run peaks with the water peaks, and we can measure concentration in line. Okay? The absorption by UVBs can only probe this region here. Okay? We can go much further. Okay? We are doing instrumentation for like measuring the quenching of the graphene solution of dye molecules. Okay? Putting graphene and we measure the concentration by the quenching of the dye. This is a new methodology. This was a master dissertation of students. 1 minute, went to the end. We are doing test instrumentation to go now to the level. Okay, so this is deep enhanced nanoscaling. Then we go to the nanoscale for spectroscopy. And this is like you go from the solution, you do your sample, and we can do AFM and run at the same time with nanometric resolution, okay? And then we can get like 1,000 spectrum from a single layer in this mess. We are trying to understand, okay? It's so rich. It's a single flake like this gives you a lot of information, and it's not the same that you assess in the micro scale, okay? A lot of differences. Cassiano is here, he is showing the test instrument, the MG Graphene stand, if you are interested. characterization, there's the vocabulary, there's a structural characterization of graphene from liquid and powder, the NPM are doing documents, a lot of documents are coming from China now, and here's the proposal. We already talked to Metro, we are planning, okay, together to make this, all these findings to become something like a MBR, MBR, the normalization, okay, to have something in Brazil, some normalization for graphene in Brazil. We are looking for partners. I think the obvious partners are CTNAM and MicroGraph, but the university, of course, are invited, and I think we should do this quickly. And to the end, really, the benchmark, we saw yesterday a benchmark. People talk about the benchmark here, not just people, the Nobel Prize, but talk about the benchmark. We also did benchmark, we have results. But I'm very uncomfortable with this huge amount of benchmark because it's very difficult to compare samples. The point is, AFM is not trivial. If you get a powder, it's not easy to redisperse. So if you measure AFM, taking powder from other people, you're doing wrong. If you don't know how to redisperse it, it is really hard. Okay? So you must explain how you do it. You must explain how you do it. There's no way to show benchmark without explaining what you're doing. This is not This is not right. Okay? So the only benchmark I can show you for sure is honest one. It's very similar to our sample. We can do this, the same treatment, okay? The samples, they look very similar. This is our conclusion. And I came to the real conclusion now. Thank you for your attention.
That's it. So we were very focused on the material. Now we have the 2.5. material stage. Okay? Then we go to the application, then we go to the composites. I hope in like 3 years I can answer this question like, okay, I did it right. For now we just do it and we measure with the parameters we have, but I don't have something this level of composites or something. In 2 or 3 years, I hope. Thank you.
Thank you.